Now we'll move on to Mr. Prakash, which we are excitedly waiting for. So the title today is Grow Up or Go Down. He has specially designed keeping in mind the challenges around. So Mr. Prakash, let me introduce him. He's a well-known leading motivational speaker. He has been doing a lot of training programs in a lot of corporates in and around India. He has recently, we have tied up with him for various training programs which we have done recently in even in the up countries. I welcome Mr. Prakash.
Okay, good afternoon. Korliye gaano. Vadivele pesna mattum nalla kathringa. Okay, we'll have a more better good afternoon. Good afternoon. நிறைய பேர் சொல்ல போல இருக்கு கொஞ்சம் முன்னாடி வாங்க நிறைய லாட் ஆஃப் சீட்ஸ்
ஓகே குட் வாட் இஸ் திஸ் டாபிக் ரியலி மீன் டு யூ இங்கிலீஷ் தங்கிலீஷ் தமிழ் எது வேணும் விச் இஸ் எந்த லாங்குவேஜ் பெட்டர் உங்களுக்கு கொஞ்சம் பீட்டர் கொஞ்சம் தமிழ் மேஜர் சுந்தரராஜன் மாதிரி ஆகிட்டாது எங்க கடையில் ரெண்டு மணி நேரம் ப்ரோக்ராம் நாலு மணி நேரம் இருக்க வேண்டியதாக ஓகே வென் வி டிசைன்ட் அ ப்ரோக்ராம் வித் திஸ் டாபிக் இன் மைண்ட் ஐ ஹேட் சர்டன் தாட்ஸ் பட் ஐ வுட் லைக் டு ஆஸ்க் யூ வாட் comes to your mind. You are all exposed to this topic before. The invite would have come to you. All of you would have got this invite, right? When this topic or when you came in, when you saw this on the board, what came to your mind? What really strikes you as when you're talking about grow up or go down? What does it really mean? Does it strike a chord? Do you have some thoughts in your mind? Is there something that you're looking forward to from this or normally in programs we have this small gift pack. This is to ensure that people participate. Good questions, good answers, will always good participation will get this. This is what I call as a motivational tool. So what are the question you ask? What are the answer you give? What's wrong with it? Okay, who decides the growth? How does the growth happen? How do we do it in an organization? Anyway, for having started participating, give me a round of applause. What we always say is something which is given free but rarely given. Today morning I was reading an article on the net called The Power of Recognition. Rarely given. Everyone wants it, nobody wants to give it. I mean, somebody participates, you give a chocolate, even then we don't feel like clapping hands. Just a show of recognition. You are saying something.
Positive attitude.
Would positive attitude alone be enough? How do you start a plan? Is it something that you go on straight into or is there something prior to that? Okay, you need to dream. From dream you go on to plan. Work harder or work smarter? What would be the difference between working hard and working smart? There are two people who participate here, one and give them a round of applause, doesn't hurt. Can you expand on that? Recently I was reading a very interesting, very small, more a joke but very powerful management thought. The three people were working on behalf of a road laying company and each had been assigned a task. One person was supposed to make the road a little bit, he has to dig the road and somebody else will come and fill the topping, the third guy has to roll it. On a given day, the person who was supposed to do the topping did not turn up. So the first person who was supposed to dig kept on digging. The third person who was present kept on sort of rolling the whole thing. Finally, what happens? Is it hard work? So where is the smart work missing? But how does it miss in our personal lives? Many of you, I am sure you here are business owners, right? So what is really happening in our lives when we all seem to put in so much of work, yet the quantum of results in terms of the growth which is happening is not apparently what we would wish it could be. So what are the missing gap? Execution comes much later, no? Prior to that, what are the things that need to happen? But dream le konja goal vanditeeng bolu. Okay, good. Anything else? I still see lot of missing links. Target your destiny. Do you need to target destiny? Destiny, I believe, is what normally happens to us, right? Are you going to target destiny or are you going to make your own destiny? You need to target destiny or do you need to make your own destiny? I am not sure if you heard my question. Do you want to target your destiny or do you want to make your own destiny? Okay, how do you make your own destiny then? It's still a lot of missing links are there. All of you have the bricks, but it doesn't still make a complete wall. We need to make a complete wall. There are a lot of holes somewhere here. So we need to still find where are we going to fill. What is missing? Is growing up optional? Or is it compulsory for you? Why? Because somebody told you? Because the market tells you? Because you fear? Or why do you say it's compulsory? And if so, what if you don't sell? Sorry? And I am asking you because you are making it sort of a, I don't have a choice kind of a situation. Is it out of fear? Is it that if I don't do, I am destined to fall? Hence, I would like to do something. Or I am looking at an organic growth where I know for sure this is what I want to, like what I was asking you. Am I very sure that I am a destiny maker or I am wanting to follow something which apparently is preordained? I am asking questions to set the base so that we can get on to something more productive, but I want you to start thinking. Where is it still missing? Wherever I go, irrespective of segment, I work in various verticals across India, whether it be the brick and mortar industry or the IT, the software segment or the SSIs or whatever it may be. Understand the needs in what sense? Again, aren't we in a sense being typecasted as Me Too's? For example, an iPod. Was it a Me Too product or was it a product which defined a standard which others, I mean till an iPod came out, I don't think any customer knew what he was going to get into. And that is one of the products which turned Apple around. And today they have, in terms of market capitalization, gone ahead of Microsoft. Did they follow the customer need or did they make their own path? They made their own path. So what is it that we are doing to make our own paths? The question that I am coming back to. Am I making my own destiny in terms of making my own path or am I taking the trodden path where everyone else is going? So obviously one of the points you are saying that your margins are getting squeezed. You are forced to work with 1%, 2%, 3% with lot of debts chasing you over a period of time. This is very, I mean, familiar with your market where you have a lot of bounce checks. Many times one single deal wipes off your annual profit. So what is it that we are doing or what is it that we intend doing which is going to make us a path breaker, or am I just focused only on some turnover numbers? At the end of the day, I want to make some margin, some profit, I'm happy with it. I'm asking you to think and then give me some answer. So I'm coming to some pertinent questions so that I can give you certain inputs. What you do with it is left to you. Still, there is something missing. Because in India, it's very easy to be a Me Too. In fact, when I interact with a lot of overseas people who come to India, they say that the potential here is so huge. These are the people who go and create the products and services world over. But today, if you really look at anything in terms of an IP, intellectual property, India almost has nothing. We are very good at services. But do we have one single OS which has made the international standard? Or very, very few. I mean, there are a few here and there breaking up. They are, you know, seeing if they can come out. There is a serious competition to the iPad. Somebody is coming to the product in. Sorry? Yeah, slowly it's coming. There are a lot of things which is happening. But do we really have something like that? I'm not saying IP in terms of a product invention. Even the way in which you approach your business, are you doing something different? One of the recent, I mean, quotes which I use in many of my programs is the definition of insanity, which I read a few years back, quite interesting. It says that doing the same thing repeatedly but expecting better results every time. Doing the same things repeatedly but expecting better results every time. Are we doing the same thing? Have you done in the last 5 to 10 years? I'll ask you another question. It may be a little bit tough for you to hear, but just think about it before you answer. At the end of the day today, if you had to decide that whatever business I am doing today, I have to stop doing, I have to start something completely afresh, what will you do? Take a sheet of paper and write an answer quickly. Whatever I am currently doing, I have to stop doing. And I have to start something afresh, maybe in the same industry, maybe in a different, what will I do? Take a sheet of paper quickly, write. Please do not ask someone else what they are writing. Something that you need to do on your own. There is no compulsion. Sorry? Right now, whatever business I am in, at this moment, I have to stop doing it. Period. It's over. I have to start afresh. The way I started 5, 10, 15, 20 years back, whatever time frame. What will I start? What will I do? I'm only asking you to think, I'm not asking you to do. Even to think, don't be. Yathi, when you room board to torture pantranga sir. No, no, no. First write, we'll let everyone write, we'll ask everyone to share. There'll be something interesting emerging. I'm not asking about the decision-making model or whatever. I'm saying, stop doing whatever you're doing today business-wise. And you have to start afresh. No capital, nothing. The only thing you have is you, that's all. You have you. Whatever goes with that. After all, finally, it's you who makes the difference. Nothing else. But very rarely people really believe in that. If that is the case, what will you do is the question. And when I ask this question, many CEOs, large companies, even they are stumped. So I don't expect any great reply or whatever. But if it, I may be surprised, but if I might find some good answers also. You never know. Have you all written? Can I have a few responses? You also have to say what you have been currently doing so that I know for sure something better or different. Just say whoever wants to share what have I been doing which I am going to give up, what am I going to start afresh. Nobody has written? Okay. Is it greatly different from what you are doing? You are only looking at focusing on something as compared to what you are currently doing. Okay. Being in the same industry, you want to move away more from sales into more of a chip level kind of a servicing, right? Okay, good. At least one person having started, maybe the second chocolate for her. A round of applause. Yeah. Healthcare you are talking about? Okay, healthcare is considered to be a $500 billion industry worldwide. Okay, good. Okay, good. Thanks. Round of applause. Anybody else from this side? No chocolates have gone this way, so. Sorry? Don't you feel it's more a business strategy? You are only talking in terms of how to revise your strategy in terms of doing more of volumes and keeping less of margins. That's okay. But I'm talking about, I have to give up what I'm doing today. But you are not sure in which line, what it is going to be, you have not thought about it. You are not thought in those lines. Okay, at least for that response, anyway, for this side, we'll round of applause. Anyone else? At least somebody is thinking a little bit different. Okay, good. Somebody raised your hand here. Yeah. Social? Social networking, okay. But you may be, as an aside, last week I had been forwarded a report by someone, the death of Facebook. I don't know if anybody had a chance to read this article. Anyone had read this article by any chance? They have predicted how the Times Warner AOL merger happened many years back, and it was a way in which actually AOL was getting out of the online business by actually, what I would say, overblowing market value and sort of cashing out. They are saying recently that Facebook has started that and they are in all probabilities likely to cash out and move away. I am just saying as that. The original idea was actually by an Indian. He actually sued him, he is going to get or he has already got an out-of-court settlement for about $400 million for having given that idea which make Mar to start Facebook in the first place. Anyway, anyone else has any other inputs? A similar concept was somebody is already doing it in Bangalore, they already started the prototypes if you have read it. At least one thing you will get for sure is a round of applause. If you really look at the question that I am asking you, where do you think I am headed? One thing which is missing in the corporate world in India, whether small, medium, large, One thing which is really missing, this is one area where I do a lot of work. What do you think is really I'm aiming at here? It's okay then. Lead, okay, lead into what? Okay, here now let's tunnel it a little bit. What are you coming to? I want to write a word on the board now. And I want your reactions to that, because that is missing in many organizations, because we are all taking the beaten path on a day-to-day basis in terms of what I call typically as living a vestibule life. You know what a vestibule is when it comes to trains? What connects multiple compartments? So you get in here, you can walk through and then get out. Likewise, we also approach our office work or even life in a vestibule syndrome. We come to office in the morning, we have a set of daily work, and we know for sure at the end of the day we'll get out and something will happen in between. Like those who have been to Mumbai, how many have been to Mumbai, Bombay? You have been to the suburban trains in the morning, you don't have to do anything, just stand there, somebody will take you and in some station you will be sent out. I am talking about a train experience as a sort of a metaphor. People understand what I am talking about. Whether we like it or not, this is something which has been happening almost all people, because you are caught up so much with your day-to-day work, with your creditors, with your vendors, like what you are saying, so much of pressure, products to handle, products to sell. People are keeping you busy with their priorities. I am saying something very significant. Your entire life, you are being kept busy with others' priorities. How many of you agree to this? So what are you going to do to change that? All of us are busy with others' priorities. When I come in the morning, the vendor decides, the customer decides, my staff decides how the business has to go, where I have to go, what products I have to sell, what quantities I have to sell. Have you lost control of your business? Have you lost control of your life, where everything what happens is more or less preordained, predetermined, that there is nothing different that you are doing in any of your day-to-day affairs? Have you done anything different every day compared to the earlier day in your work, or is it more or less similar? Check values are different, bank is different, client name is different, invoice number is different, product code is different, finally it's all same tamasha, right? In this kind of a situation, is growth something that you are opting for, or is it being thrust on you? You don't decide your targets. Somebody decides your targets. Do you have a choice of deciding your targets? Unless it's higher. If you want to do more than what the vendor wants you to do, he'll be very happy to take that kind of a number. But otherwise, you are compelled, even what products to order for, what are the market mix, what kind of products I have to choose, what if I buy, what will come free with that, what are the promo, what are the ad budgets, all these are interlinked. So what do you really have in terms of a choice that you can make in your growth? Do you really have control on your growth today? When I say grow up, it's quite easy to say, yes, I have to decide to grow up, but have I made the decision of growing up? Very rarely we think, so when I'm asking you to think, it's a little bit difficult, because in our day-to-day job, we don't need to think. Like many of you initially when I asked, you're all only talking about execution, 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 smarter way, faster turnaround cycles, better collection mechanisms, you know, better prospecting techniques, better lead generation methods. If you really look at the whole concept in terms of the ideas which I want you to generate, there is one thing which is seriously missing in many of the corporate companies in India. There are many who do, but we do this as an exercise for many of them. What we call does this word ring a bell? Does it really mean anything to you? This word never came up in any of the discussions we had. We had dreams, we had goals, we had so many things. How many of us have a vision about where we are headed? I'm asking each one of you, because I believe that growth is optional and I need to have a say in what I want to grow into. Maybe the vendors have a role to play, the clients have a role to play, the market has a role to play, but my role has to be the biggest, for which I need to be clear where I want to be. If I had to ask you to take a sheet of paper and write, We are in 2011 now. I'll give you a 5-year span. 2016, the date being 9th of January, if I had to walk in into a room of people who I have met 5 years before, what would they know me as on that day? Did you get my question right? 5 years from now, if I had to walk into a room of people whom I have met 5 years back on the same day, what would I want them to know me as? Can you take a sheet of paper quickly, right? I'll show you how to create a vision in a very short span, though it is not the exact exercise you need to do, it's much more elaborate. Just take a sheet of paper, it doesn't hurt. 9/1/2016, I walk into a room of people who I have met 5 years back, who I have known well, and on that day I am moving in and they are all waiting to receive me. What would be the occasion? You can decide what the occasion is. You can also say, on this day they are all waiting to receive me because I have become, or I am this, or I have started this, whatever. Take a sheet of paper, let your imagination run wild. Don't restrict based on what you think you are. Just write whatever comes to your mind. It can be as crazy as saying, I am now the number one movie director in India, or I have started a party, or I have become the CMD of Infosys, whatever it may be. With that laughter. You're not writing? Thinking.
It's about us.
About you. I, me, myself. This is not an exercise normally that can be done in about 5-10 minutes time. For companies where we do visioning exercise, sometimes it takes between 6 months to 1 year. It's interesting. We'll capitalize on that a little bit later. I'll use that as an example. Anybody else? It's your life. I mean, you need to have the confidence to share what you have written. If you don't even have the confidence to share what you have written, the chances of you achieving it are... Okay, good. You want to become an entrepreneur or
CEO or MD of your own company and want to have a large gathering of all your customers in the same ballroom or a similar ballroom somewhere. Okay, good. Good thought.
Anyone else? Yeah. Okay, good. Do something great like what HP and Epson have done in the printing industry and be acknowledged for that. It's a good vision. Like that. Give him a round of applause. Because to think big, you don't need anything else other than your ability to think. So don't think about, no, I'm only a small fry, what will I do? I don't think Ambanis or anybody else thought like that when they started off. Who else? Yeah. Okay, good. Something similar like what we heard here. Yes. Okay, want to have a peaceful life 5 years from now. Okay, good. Why not? Yeah. Millions and zillions and... Okay, then. You would have become a great investor. Another Warren Buffett in the making. I mean, why not? Why do we have to laugh? No harm in thinking like that. Yeah.
I want this day in my life to be changed. To I need to set my sail, let the wind blow. What should my destiny?
10 times what?
Whatever I do today,
10 times.
So free,
10 times more punctual. Okay, good. One last response. This side has been quite silent. From the time I have been sitting here, I think even during the program participation, very well also, that side has been very participate. Anybody else here who wants to share one last input before we start something else which is interesting? Okay, now to get back to this vision that you have written, I'll come back a little bit later on what to do with the vision and how to go a little bit further. What are the ingredients that you need for this vision to become reality in life? What ingredient, what do you need to make this vision a reality in your life? First is?
Implement.
Implement, okay. Implement what?
Whatever you think.
Setting the goals, okay. Planning. Implementing, then?
Positive thinking,
then?
Fast
research, fast access to?
Fast action.
Fast action, okay, then? Sorry? Most vital? If you're going to, that's what you're going to chase at the end of the rainbow, how can you have that at the beginning of the rainbow is a question somebody else might ask. If you have to have money to chase money, why do I have to chase money in the first place? I'm just kidding. Anyone else? I'm still not finding interesting answers here. I'm finding typical and bookish answers. Anybody else? I'm looking at something interesting here, different. Because I'm setting the base for something I'm going to show you now. I'm going to show you a video, which has no connection to whatever you're doing or talking right now about vision or anything else, but I'll bring the connect later. I'm still looking at something which is a missing element. I even gave a clue when I was asking these questions. What is the power and strength? Where does it come from? What is the source? You are getting somewhere on track. I am just seeing if I can pull you on. Planning is something word which has been used very often here in this room. Strategy. Okay. If we can expand on what he is saying, we can somewhere get to an answer which would make a lot of sense to us.
Efforts, putting the efforts and monitoring the growth.
That's more on the strategy, implementation, all those things. He spoke about the power and strength, which is somewhere coming on track, but I am just seeing how to extract a little bit more from that. Innovation, vision, innovation, ideas. Where does it all come from? As you were saying, the power and strength of whom? Are you going to externalize the power and strength? Sorry? Self-belief for what reason? What happens the moment you step out of this room, even before you step out of the room, is the doubt that you have whether I will do this or not. Not, sorry? Attitude comes later. The doubt, do you already have it in you for you even to say that my vision will come true? If I had to forcibly push you to the corner and say that the vision will not work, most probably all of you in this room will agree it won't work and quit. I'll take a bet on that.
Can-do attitude.
Can-do attitude is easy to say verbally. Do we really believe in it? The answer that he gave was really, I mean, on a scale of 1 to 10, it's almost 9, self-belief. How many of us really have the self-belief and what do we have in us to strengthen the self-belief further to bring the power and strength that is essential? It's quite easy to create a vision, actually speaking. All it needs is that you need to have certain thinking power and you need either an internal or an external person to help you. And they can come and set up a vision. But do you really believe in that vision? Do you have the power and strength? Do you have the conviction? Do you have the self-belief to go after the vision till it is really achieved? I mean, some of you gave an interesting idea of starting a utility services. Somebody else said something really, really big. I mean, I would say hats off to this person. He at least dared to think of something which many people would not. He said, let me become another company, HP or Epson. I don't know whether you really believe it or not, or whether you say it for the sake of saying in the session here. But he said something which is really what creates large organizations and the seed of thought which takes people. How many of us have it in us to take it through till the end? Do you have it in you to take it through till the end? Do you believe in yourself so much? Can you build further power and strength that is essential. Because some of the visions that came out were more or less more like business goals. They are not really visions. Visions could hardly be said to be one or two which I heard in this room. The rest were more like business goals. Still good enough. Still good enough. Not a bad start for a vision. Because finally visions get broken down into goals. After all, normally when you look at the process, we look at a very large canvas and start creating what we call as the dreams. The dreams which are really large, universal, which covers, encompasses the entire world. And from the dreams that we build, we bring it down to what we call as visions, which are more like, I have a larger canvas, I've created a dream, in that dream I just take one portion and focus on it, that becomes a vision. And the vision is further broken down into, good, vision normally is broken into goals. How many goals? How many goals? The goals can be hundreds of them. For example, let us take this gentleman's statement that he wanted to start a, by 2016, 9th of January, he would have started a company which is equivalent to that of HP and Epson in printing. What are the possibilities of the goals that he has to achieve towards that vision? Humongous. I mean, it's just innumerable. There is so much. Every step that you take is sort of a goal. And you have your short-term goals, you have your mid-term goals, you have your long-term goals. There is so much to be done for him before he can realize that vision. And at every point of time, what are you going to meet? You're going to meet challenges. You're going to meet naysayers, people who are around you who say, it's not possible. Why are you wasting your time? It's not going to happen. You're not capable of doing. Nobody in India has done it. This is not meant for us. This is meant for somebody else to do. Let's just stick to distribution or dealership. This is what we are. I'm not saying that quit your current business. I'm saying when you start thinking really big. For example, I didn't hear anyone saying either, I want to become the number one service industry in IT in India. I want to be the number one IT service provider. Not in terms of just opening multiple shops, but defining standards which are completely different, which have never been heard of before, which may not even exist today, but I want to set benchmarks which everyone will think of following worldwide. Things like that really create interesting vision because that creates, vision typically create what is known as possibilities. Possibilities lead to goals. Goals then can later be broken down into strategies, execution. For that you can hire, like what you said, hundreds of people. India is full of talented people who are ready for being hired. But very rarely do you have CEO material, people who can think of a vision or think of a long-term aim. 5 years from now, 10 years from now, what do we really see? Me creating something out of myself 5-10 years from now. Not in terms of a sheer achievement. I'm not looking at saying, just let me achieve something 5 years from now in terms of monetary turnover, target, profits, all those things are normal. I want to do something which is path-breaking. I want to do something. When I say I want to do something path-breaking, is it a vision or is it a dream? Is it a vision or a dream? It is a dream. I want to do something path-breaking is universal, can be anything. And I want to do something path-breaking in a specific industry, for example, or a specific vertical. Then it becomes a vision. And then I take that vision, break them down into hundreds of goals. Now I have for my next year what you call as a business plan. To achieve this business plan, what do? I start strategizing. I create strategies and then go back to that last element what you said, resources, finance is one of them. Today VCs, so many bankers, so many people with funding are looking at people with ideas which can be backed up with a proper business plan. When you have something like that, people are willing to fund you. Every great enterprise that you see today was a very small thought of a vision of a person. That's why they say visionaries are so difficult. It's quite easy to find people who can execute. All you have to do is say, do this, people will do it for you. Enough people, I mean, you pay them enough salary, take care of them well and whatever, they'll do it for you, they'll stick on. If they are not there, somebody else will come. But do you have it in you to create a vision? Are you a visionary? when you become a visionary, you will start attracting talent. Of course, you need a lot of other resources to go around. As they say that you can't just keep building castles in the air. When you keep building castles in the air, we talk about creating vision. To convert vision, a castle in the air, to a proper structure, we need to bring the pillars of the castle down to the earth and put them down. Then the castle takes sort of a permanent shape. Otherwise, it will all be a pack of cards floating around. So, to create a vision is not sufficient. We need to go a little bit further in that. Why am I setting a base in this? Coming back to that point, finally the whole thing boils down to me. Do I have the guts to think big? Do I have the guts to think differently? Do I have the wherewithal in me to create a vision when I am very comfortable with what I am doing? One of the points that is essential for visionaries is their ability to make themselves uncomfortable when things are going well. When things are going well, I am getting my margin. At the end of the month, I am getting my money. My family is happy. I have some little bit of reserves. Things are fine. At that point of time, do you have the guts to do something which is uncomfortable? This is one of the strength of people who lead great organizations. They are willing to give up things which are comfortable. They are willing to suspend things which are comfortable. The line being, make yourself uncomfortable when